Inflammation is your body's way of responding to an injury, allergen, and infection. It is why a sprained ankle doubles in size and why you run a fever when your body is fighting a virus or bacteria. The problem is when your body has prolonged or chronic inflammation, because it can put you at risk of long-term health conditions like heart disease and diabetes. Your body sees certain foods as irritant, and this can cause the immune system to go on attack mode and in turn lead to inflammation. Welcome back. In today's video, we'll discuss foods that cause inflammation to help you decide which foods to limit for better health. Number one is added sugar. Table sugar and high fructose corn syrup directly leads to an elevation of inflammatory markers in our bloodstream. Consuming foods that contain added refined sugar, such as candy, sugary beverages, salad dressing, condiments such as ketchup and barbecue sauce, and desserts is linked to diabetes and obesity and increases inflammation, while naturally occurring sugars such as those found in fruits do not. Number two is trans fats. These are fats that have hydrogen added to them to make them more stable by changing them from liquid form to a solid form. They lead to an elevation of C-reactive protein, which is an important non-specific marker of inflammation. Because trans fats make food last longer, they are generally found in foods such as frozen pizza, prepackaged pastries, fried foods, and some microwavable popcorns. If you're looking at food labels, look for and avoid hydrogenated or partially hydrogenated fats. Number three is refined carbohydrates. Refined grains have been stripped of fiber, vitamins, and minerals that would otherwise make them anti-inflammatory. They have a very high glycemic index. Glycemic index is how much your blood sugar spikes after you eat something. Research has directly linked foods that have a greater impact on your blood sugar with increased inflammation that puts one at high risk for obesity, metabolic syndrome, type 2 diabetes, and other inflammatory conditions. Examples of refined carbs include white pasta, white bread, white rice, some cereals, white flour tortillas. These high glycemic index foods fuel the production of advanced glycation end products, which are harmful compounds that are formed when protein or fat combine with sugar and stimulates inflammation. Therefore, it is best to choose whole grains and 100% whole grain products whenever possible. Number four, it's alcohol. Excessive alcohol use has been shown to cause inflammation. The breakdown of alcohol in the gastrointestinal tract can lead to chronic inflammation in the intestines, which has severe consequences for health, including increased cancer risk, inflammatory bowel disease, immunity issues, bloating, and weight gain. To reduce inflammation, it is best to avoid alcohol or use in moderation, which is one drink per day for women and two drinks for men. Also, when you choose cocktail drinks, be aware of the calories in the drinks. Liquor mixers can have a lot of added sugar. Minimize calories and added sugar from alcohol by choosing a glass of wine that has less sugar, a light beer, or mixing liquor with low or no calorie mixers. Number five is processed meat. Processed meats are high in saturated fats, which can cause inflammation in fat tissues. Studies suggest that processed meat is linked with increased inflammatory response in our body and may increase the risk of colon cancer. These meats include bacon, hot dog, pepperoni, smoked meat, and deli meat. If you must have these meats, you want to look for the ones that do not contain nitrates or nitrites. Number six is vegetable and seed oils. Research suggests that most people are way over consuming omega-6 fatty acids, largely due to the heavy use of vegetable oils like corn oil, soybean oil, sunflower oil, and peanut oil in processed and convenience foods. And it seems that we are under consuming omega-3 fatty acids, which are anti-inflammatory powerhouses. The overall effect is an imbalance that may contribute to low-grade systemic inflammation. Therefore, try to get good sources of omega-3 each week by eating fish like salmon, as well as walnuts, flax seeds, and chia seeds. Also, be aware of the oils you cook with or consume, as oils contain a mix of fatty acids. So choose the ones that have higher proportion of omega-3, such as extra virgin oil, avocado oil, walnut oil, and flaxseed oil. The goal is to consume a healthy balance of omega-6 and omega-3 fatty acids. Excess consumption of omega-6 can trigger the body to produce pro-inflammatory chemicals. Number seven is gluten. gluten. This is for people who are gluten sensitive or have certain health conditions such as celiac disease. Most research seems to indicate that consuming gluten may lead to inflammation in people with gluten sensitivity or certain health conditions like celiac disease. But eating foods with gluten has now been linked to inflammation in people who do not have sensitivity. So if you have gluten sensitivity, try to eat food that are gluten-free whenever possible. With all these foods, you will need to pay attention to your body response to them and see if certain foods cause more inflammation than others. Remember, everything is in moderation, but if you're feeling inflamed, it is good to skip these foods. If this has been helpful, hit that like button and be sure to subscribe for more health related videos. Until next time, stay healthy and remember, health is the greatest wealth.